Hi guys, welcome to Gusto Reactions once again. Thank you so much for always liking, sharing, subscribing, telling everyone about what we do right here at Gusto TV. And once again, Lala in the building with his Gusto shirt. Best, you see, best is sure. Anyways, today we talk about Tenny and Techno. These two have been quite, regarded as two of the best when it comes to talent, in the industry. Mm-hmm. These guys have been really, really good. 2020 has been quite silent, especially for Tenny, right?
Oh yeah, I mean, by her standards, by the standards she set for herself, mm-hmm. I think this has been her first miss of the year. Since she first bust, I think 2017.
Yeah,
this has been her first miss. I mean, she hasn't been active like that this year. So,
mm-hmm.
But yeah, she's almost getting ready for big things. So,
and Techno,
if you look at it, Techno had not really been quite like that. But it's just that his releases had not really made an impact
mm-hmm.
this year. But then again, he has teased his
mm-hmm.
album,
mm-hmm.
so we're looking forward to that. But then. If you were to put them in the same sentence, perhaps Techno should be on a different level because he's been at it for years.
Yes, yeah.
And we haven't actually seen anybody of work, whether an EP or an album from him.
So okay, now these two artists do not have a body of work.
No, Tenny does have.
Oh, Tenny has the EP, the Billionaire EP, yes. Yeah. But they do not have an album. Yes, Techno doesn't even have a body of work at all. Not an EP, mm-hmm. not an album.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Tenny's Billionaire EP, were you impressed by that particular body of work?
Well, it's difficult because I could only point to one or two tracks on the EP,
mm-hmm.
which now made the whole end results like an underwhelming
mm-hmm.
Project. But then Billionaire, which is a smash hit, was off the project, so you could say that was a success. But then again, apart from Billionaire, there was no really other track we could point to. Then she came around and did an EP with Neptune
mm-hmm.
and had decent. Almost smash it songs on there, which was really impressive. It was an improvement on what we had on Billionaire. So first one was sort of a mid-level, but mm-hmm. then the next one was an improvement. So perhaps what she's going to drop next would be a major improvement from what she has done.
Well, 2018 we had Case from Tenny, the Entertainer,
mm-hmm.
and then just a month after that we had Uyomeyo. Mm-hmm. Now 2018 was a very, very quite impressive year. Tenny was one of, if not the hottest
female
Nigerian artists at that, female artist as well mm-hmm. at that time. Tenny was everywhere mm-hmm. on the shows.
Yeah.
Now going back to 2019, Billionaire EP and everything, mm-hmm. quite mid for Tenny, but a couple of people expected a whole lot more. So you know what, Tenny is going to really blow up in 2020
mm.
and take over everywhere. Has she taken over in 2020?
No, she certainly has not. She has not taken over in 2020. Perhaps she's been strategizing or perhaps working on that album, which we know she's working on.
Mm.
But then it hasn't been the most impressive year for her. If we're going to rank it in terms of since she made her first foray into the industry, this has been the most underwhelming from her. But then she seems to have woken up with a new single, so I think that's going to do well for her.
So looking at that, would you say you're disappointed by her activities for the year?
Yes, certainly. Actually, for the year, I've been below par, so not impressed. But then, she has a new song.
Tenny has told us to dance with that brand new song, Joe.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on it?
Well, Joe is really a nice song. It was a case of classic Tenny. We know she has mad melodies. We know she's a good songwriter, and she knows how to make people dance with her songs. And that was a classic example of what she can deliver, which is on Joe. But then, just because what I really fear for is because people, she has not been everywhere this year.
Mm.
She has not really been everywhere. Although the Neptune EP was it at the start of the year,
I'm
so sure. But then, apart from that, she hasn't really been in most places. So that might affect. People may be slowly. We're talking conversations of best female artists, and we're not mentioning Tenny because she has been nowhere to be. She hasn't been consistent this year. So. I feel if she doesn't buck up with the promotions of this new song, it might be a forgotten track.
Well, 2020 had Tenny secure the Pepsi deal, the Budweiser deal as well, TomTom deal, Glow deal, in a year that a lot of people seem quiet for her. I mean, a couple of these deals were already struck, you know, in 2019, but were announced.
They're the results of the hard work she put in.
Yes,
2018, 2019, and that's the result of it.
Yeah,
but it wasn't necessarily because of what she has done in 2020, which I feel she hasn't done much.
Okay, we'll come back to Tenny, but let's go to Tekno.
Well, Tekno's Old Romance, we finally,
the album is finally coming.
Finally, have a date. So, I mean, people are expecting so much from Tekno, but then this year we've had songs like Sudden, had Put It In. Which was, that is song that he had strippers on the Lekki Epe toll gates. I forgot the name of that song.
Oh, okay. I think it's isn't it Agege?
Yeah, Agege.
Agege. That was 2019.
But this year, I mean, his the build up to his album as is
and Skeleton released last year, but of course totally blew off this
Yes, and thanks to the video, because the video did massive wonders. I mean, the video is so catchy, so impressive to watch. The video had similarities with this guy, Tanzanian guy, Diamond Platinum. Yeah, the red and white beats, and also the beat where he had the bottle of beer, and actually had what's the name of this guy, the Dada guy. Name's not coming to my head.
What's his name?
The Dada guy.
Chris Beat?
No, he's a singer.
Oh, okay,
but he had dreads, Solid Star.
Solid Star.
Had Solid Star vibe on some Solid Star videos from the far. But it was really, really good to watch the dancers, the whole scenery and everything. It was mad. I think TG shot that.
Yeah,
that's one of the reasons the song, you can say, was a hit this year, because yes, it brought it back to life. And then his newest offering with all the girls shaking behind.
Enjoy.
Make Bonaboy go see that video. enjoy. Not enjoy. There's like Put It In.
Put It In.
Like, I don't understand. I can't play Put It In at home because of my daughter.
That video. It's so X.
Tekno quietly did his thing this year. I mean, that's like the second video with that sort of thing.
I mean, the first one was Agege one with the girls and everything. But looking at that, a lot of people still do not see Tekno as an artist that did a lot in 2020. Why?
Well, see, he's played the singles game for so long. Like, he's known for a singles guy who has been able to keep it a book and be at that B list for quite a long time. So,
Is Tekno B list?
What is it, A list?
No, I'm asking you.
Yeah, B list now.
Whoa, okay, continue.
What do you think?
Continue.
No, just give me a sign. Like,
well, I think, but there was at some point, Tekno was an A list artist.
Yeah, he's moved past that now. At the time of Pana, with the numbers Pana did, you consider him an A-list artist. But he's taking a step down in my books.
Okay. Due to
not being active, and the fact that
he's been active. There was not a year.
But how big are these songs that we're talking about? How big is Put It In?
So what makes you think that you know, no, Skeleton was a huge song.
Yes, agreed.
Put In was a mid song.
Okay.
Enjoy.
But if you are giving it, but how many elite artists do we have in this Nigeria?
Okay, no, Tekno was A list at some point.
Yes.
So I'm gonna go back to you.
Yeah.
Do you think that if Tekno drops this album, do you think the whole Tekno, you know, relevance in terms of fading off is because he has not dropped an album?
It's a combination of things.
They got tired of his sound.
One, not people getting tired of his sound. Maybe perhaps. I mean, when I listen to songs like the latest one that he had,
Enjoy,
like, that's just classic Tekno of 3 years ago. So are we now saying, is Tekno telling us those are new songs, or songs that he has planned for a long time that he hasn't released, that is now? The biggest mistake you can do for this album is give us sounds from when he had Pana and what's it called, these other sounds that went global. That's the biggest mistake he can do.
So what should Tekno do on this new album?
Well, vibes and inshallah, because it's his first album. I don't think people will be too hard on him, and I'm not expecting a mad debut album, because the time for that has really passed.
Has passed.
If you have done that around when Pana was a thing and was the song, almost the song of the year.
I was gonna ask you that. Yeah. When you think was the perfect time he should have dropped that album?
That was the period. The period they had Pana, Diana. I mean, imagine having those kind of songs around that period and having an album. I mean, that would have cemented the album as one of the best.
How would you react if Tekno brings a couple of these songs into this new album?
How would I react? I won't be surprised.
He brings a Pana into the album.
I won't be surprised because I'm like, for the sake of not flopping, he's gonna need the numbers of those kind of songs. But then nothing says he can't. Well, you can put it as bonus tracks. Bonus tracks, but they will have the
song of 4 or 5 years ago.
Maybe today. We had the video bring out a song of.
I just knew you're going to come up with that. I knew.
That's what I said. I won't be surprised.
I knew you were going to come up with that one, Lala.
Okay. Sorry, BMW. Sorry.
If Tekno drops an album, you're saying people won't be too hard on him?
No, people won't be too hard.
Why
on him.
Do you think so?
The time to have like critically criticized or look at
it. You don't think it will make them want to say, okay, you've taken this long to drop a debut album, it has to be good. I mean, you can't go for so long without an album and then come to drop a mid album for us.
No, people will not look at it that way.
You think so?
People will not look at it that way. Because the time had passed.
Okay.
Right now, I think this album is just for him to fulfill all righteousness.
So you're saying that people are not anticipating the album?
I'm looking at online, looking at the streets. People are not. I'm not like I'm shocked, but I don't think people are anticipating it like that.
Have people moved on from Tekno?
I won't say not just yet, but slowly. Slowly.
Okay, so
he's been at it for years. Yeah. I mean, but when was holiday? Was it 2012 or 13?
Yeah.
So that's like 7 years.
Around for a year.
It's hard for you to keep up the consistency for that long with singles. He's done it with singles, but this time with an album, I don't think people will be hard. I don't think people are looking forward to a mad, except for industry enthusiasts and his core fans. But come on.
So would you say that's like the biggest ever mistake of Tekno's career?
Yeah, it took so long to get this album out. I mean, he had several opportunities to have dropped an album or even an EP. And that's why some till today is still underappreciated or underregarded in the awards.
So I remember a time Eddie's putting on the next rated thing, they say, okay, because you don't have an EP, you don't have an album yet. He said that was disrespect.
Well, those are the terms of the awards.
He rejected it.
He rejected it, but then again, did he submit his content for that category? Eddie's just decided to just maybe then head this thing is to collect submissions. But then he can tell me that disrespect, but then if he hasn't dropped an EP, then they can nominate him for that category because that's where he falls into according to them.
Okay, back to Tenny right now. Yeah. Have people moved on from Tenny?
No, not just yet. She's been quiet. It's allowed after having like two massive years. It's allowed for her to, I mean, re-strategize and...
Two massive years. 2019 was a massive year for Tenny.
Yes, 2019 was a massive year. 2019 gave us Billionaire.
That's...
And Yuwa Mayo?
No, 2018 was Yuwa Mayo.
Really?
Yeah.
But no.
But it blew in 2019.
2019 totally was massive for Tenny. Yes.
Okay, so two massive years, one very, very underperforming
year. Which understandable, like if you don't take a personal interest in her life. I mean, I went personally to her YouTube and watched her episode of Triple X Live and things like that. You get to see more about Tenny and I mean her family, how she goes about her business. And fun fact for the album, I think Fuse produces a lot for Tenny these days. He also produced Billionaire, I think.
Yeah, Billionaire.
So if Fuse is gonna be on an album, for me, it's to be a smash.
Okay, so you think that people are anticipating Tenny?
Yes, people are
much more than Tekno.
Yes,
much more than Tekno.
Yes,
but Tekno has had a better year than Tenny, according to my own books.
Yeah.
So you don't think they are anticipating Tekno much more than Tenny?
Well, no, people don't know what to expect with Tekno. Is the album is coming so late? Tenny has barely had 3 years in the industry, and then she's having an album. She set out to drop an album, and then the album was supposed to drop this year, but I think it's been moved to next year. But then from those episodes of Triple X Live, she says she's completed it. I saw the episode where she said, oh, they were now praying and say, oh, thank God, I've finished my album. So the new album is ready, locked in. I think Tekno at first said it was 4th, then he said it was 10th.
Okay. So, okay, let's even leave the anticipation alone right now about whose album people are anticipating more.
Yeah.
Which album do you think would bang out of these two? I mean, these guys do not have an album yet.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Yeah. I think both albums would bang. I'll be equally listening to both albums as per my which other work I think. As per my job. So but then the one I have a like I think I would lean towards more. I think it's gonna be the Tenny one. Mm. Like I'm a big fan of Tenny, so I would want to see how well she delivers on this album, because we know that the first EP was not as good, the second joint EP was decent.
Mm.
But then I really want to see her on the stretch of songs on this album.
What do these guys need to do to bounce back before we go?
Bounce back, drop hit songs. Tenny has Joe right now. If she pushes it well, then yes, I think
has the potential.
Techno has
Enjoy.
Allow me. Let's see that techno is classic techno.
Yeah.
So it seems what we're gonna get on Old Romance is classic techno. But are we not tired of the classic techno? Are we getting something new from techno?
Are you tired of the classic techno?
I think I am.
So what do you think the techno should do? I mean, techno has always been techno.
Yeah, techno has always been techno. But then these sounds, the singles he has dropped this year, it took a while for Put It In to kick in.
Yeah.
And then Enjoy does not sound like something like a new sound that people are listening to.
Enjoy is Diana 2.0.
Oh, thank you for saying that, but I didn't really think about it like that. But Diana 2.0, and yeah. Remember when Diana was released?
Yeah.
So that's we're going back in time with that sound, with techno. So have we not heard enough of that sound?
But what if techno says to you today that he's done like a survey and all of that, and people seem to like the old techno more because that classic techno was what made techno, was what made him, was what people loved and everything. So you don't think that classic techno actually, you know, is him going back in time and say, you know what, let me pick this formula that worked for me at that time and bring it back to 2020?
Well, I can't fault him, reason being, I made the same excuse for Liu Kesh when he dropped his EP and said the only way to usher in a new sound is to first give people a taste of what you've your forte. So if he's doing that, fine. But then on the album, I would expect newer sounds.
Mm.
I wouldn't want to hear things like Diana 2.0 or Pana 2.0.
Songs sounding the same.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to hear those. So, but then if he goes, if he's just ushering us back into what techno to be, and then just switch it up with the different type of sounds in the album, then all well and good. I'm gonna be back to hail him and say, Baba, you delivered a dope album.
Okay, so I have before we go, I actually have like an observation.
Yeah.
Now I've observed that techno as an artist is very one-dimensional, in that I'm monodimensional. You get. And I don't think it's a bad thing. It's just pray that people don't get tired of it. Jogodo is a classic techno sound.
Yeah.
Diana, Pana, Enjoy.
Yeah.
Agege is not that classic techno.
No.
So if he gives us a bit of Agege,
actually, is, if you think about it, well, that's like classic techno.
That's classic techno as well.
Yeah.
You understand? Now, if he puts in a bit of the streets alongside the classic techno, just maybe we might have a very good album.
Maybe.
Maybe.
But then I wouldn't want to write him up and say no, he's not going to deliver a dope album. I'm just saying the anticipation levels. It's just I don't see a general populace of music, Nigerian music lovers
really expecting.
I'm not seeing the activities online that Techno's album is coming. Oh,
like Davido and Wizkid, yeah, in Lagos.
Obviously, he doesn't have that kind of fan base, we know. But then I'm not seeing that anticipation level. Like, I can't really see it. All I'm seeing is tweets. He's getting a lot of retweets, likes, and all those. But and the people are not going out of the way. So Techno's album is coming. It's coming. Maybe a week. I mean, before 10th, we'll see
that. Yeah, hopefully, we're going to see Techno drop that particular one. And of course, people will love it. Old Romance drops on the 10th of December 2020. I mean, there's been a whole lot, and techno seems to want to close the year. Just maybe Tenny would have a rethink and drop the album this year, or we don't know. But of course, what do you think about Techno, Old Romance album dropping very soon? The techno influence, how strong is it at the moment? The Tenny influence, how strong is it at the moment? What do you think about Enjoy, the new single by Techno, and of course that one Joe? Tenny says you should dance. that one new single by Tenny the Entertainer. I want to hear from you. Let us know, comment down there, and of course we'll be right there to respond, reply, of course listen to every one of you. We want to see those comments, we want to hear from you, we want to know. Of course that Zoom call,
yeah,
is going
I,
to
I think we should probably put a tentative date to that.
yes in the next episode of Gospel Reaction we're going to have a date for the Zoom call. Everybody who wants to join in should please signify by sending in a text or an email.
No, we'll do an RSVP, like
an RSVP form, thing.
Fill
okay.
it out and then
which you're going to fill and everything. So yes guys, we're going to put it at the top of every of the comments just so that at least you can click to fill the form. We love you guys and we would always be there for you the same way you have always been there for us. 2020 has been amazing and we still have a whole lot more to deliver to every one of you. We'll see you on the next reactions. Peace.